want to play ray shooter with light gun. You know that there are solutions to make light gun, but you have neither the time nor the knowledge to do it. If you have remotes and a classic USB Wii bar, then it is possible using the program Lichtknarre and while enjoying a very good position. Hi, it's Ginzu. It's been a while. Hope you are well. So beware, a little disclaimer. It doesn't work with the Mayflash Dolphin bar. It already has a built-in Bluetooth module and it is not compatible. Maybe one day. Moreover, the classic Wii bar is easily found on the internet and it is not expensive. Concerning the support of the Bluetooth, you will need a compatible USB dongle. I recommend you the UB400 Nano, which is fully compatible with the program. If you want more details about this and how to make your Wiimotes compatible with Windows, take a look at my previous video of Lichtknarre. I explain everything. Lichtknarre is a program that allows you to play ray shooters with Wiimotes. Originally, it works with a system of 4 infrared LEDs that you have to make yourself. I integrated this system to my arcade machine last May and I can even switch with the LED system for the gun 4IR. To start, you will have to choose to place the Wii bar at the top of the screen or at the bottom of the screen. And it is also possible to place two LEDs on each side of the screen, but in this case, it will not be a Wii bar anymore. In my case, for my test, I placed the Wii bar at the bottom of my screen, and I centered it well. Then I tapped it because it should not move after calibration. We start by launching the program and we synchronize the Wiimotes. If we use a true LED tracking system like the Wii bar, there is however a disadvantage. You have to stand further from the screen to be able to enjoy it fully. Indeed, with a 4 LED system we are really closer to the screen. The novelty is here, where you can now change the tracking system. Previously, only the 4 LED system was present. The program can remember the remote listening to each player. Here we see that only one remote is active, but the program has kept in memory a second remote for the player 2 that I have already used. The game preview will allow you to see that the camera is well taken into account and that the LED works. Then you just have to click on default gun calibration to calibrate the remotes. For the moment, the calibration is global. All the remotes will have the same calibration. The calibration of the two LED tracker mode is a little bit different, and I personally prefer it to the 4 LED system. Also, it is a little bit too sensitive in my opinion. As I said before, it is imperative to move back enough to be able to calibrate and play. I have 32-inch screen and I have to stand about 3 meters, almost 10 feet. Then position yourself well in the center of the screen. Then aim and shoot on each green cross. If the shot is not taken into account, slowly move the remote forward or backward and shoot again. Notifications appear on the screen. Test the aiming by aligning your eye with the sight, and if you are not satisfied, you can start again or adjust the offsets. The calibration is set once and remains in the program's memory, which means that you don't have to do it again later, but you can adjust it at any time if you are not satisfied. But you can add a fisheye or wide-angle lens to reduce the distance between you and the screen. On this subject, Geeknoarium and Sato have already designed lens holder to position the lens in front of the Wiimote in 3D printing. I add links in the description of the video if you are interested. To play, the program must run in the background. You just have to enjoy it. Have a good game. If you want more content, don't hesitate to give me a like or subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching the video and see you soon!